All right, everyone, welcome to today's circuit workout. I know that you typically all do three circuits. I'm going to try to squeeze a fourth in today. We'll see if we can accomplish that or not. Let's go ahead and start our warm up by just walking in place, walking back and forth, just getting our body moving. Kind of take this time to notice what feels tight, what feels stretched, so we can focus on that as we continue to warm up. I do have a question for you all. When I'm setting my timer right now, I have it set to 30 seconds of activity followed by 15 seconds of rest. Would you like me to do the 20 seconds of rest, or would you like it 15? Would you like it any other number? Feel free to shout out to me.
I think 15 seconds is fine for me.
Yeah, okay. 20 seems a little long. 15 or 10, I think, would be good.
Yeah,
okay.
Agreed.
We'll start with 15 and then we can adjust as needed. Just trying to make you all sweat today. And I might regret it because I'm doing it too, but we'll work with it. Okay. Let's go to arm circles next. So get your arms in a T shape, fingertips point in opposite directions, arms level with your shoulders. Start rolling your arms in small circles forward, getting bigger each time you go, so that you're working through your full range of motion. And if it's okay, I have some pump up music that'll play in the background just during exercise, not during explanations. If anyone vetoes that, let me know and I can turn it off. All right.
I'm good either way for the music, but okay. no objection if you turn it off.
Okay, great. Let's reverse directions here, starting small again, rolling our arms backwards, getting bigger each time we go, working through our full range of motion. And shake your arms out, wiggle it out. Let's get to glute kicks. So for our glute kicks, we bring our heel to our bottom and then switch every other, alternating when you do your glute kick. Try to keep your leg that's bending, keep that knee pointed down. That'll get you the most stretch out of your quads or your thigh muscles. And let's do alternating arms involved as well. So arms bent at a 90 degree angle, opposite leg kicks back, opposite arm swings forward and up. Moving at your own pace. I start out slow, feel the nice stretch, but maybe I'll pick up my pace as the warm-up moves on. All right, let's move to high knees. Get those knees up nice and high towards the ceiling. Again, moving those arms in opposition. So left knee lifts up, right arm swings forward. Same with opposite side, moving at your own pace. And I have a new set sequence, whole new workout today, because I'm just not sure what you guys have been doing. So if you have any questions as we go, please let me know. If you've already done an exercise, you don't need a long explanation. Feel free to just tell me. All right, we're going to switch to windmill toe touches. So feet wider than shoulder width apart, toes point forward, arms into a T shape. Bend at the waist, opposite hand reaches towards opposite foot, come back up and alternate. Pushing your hips back as you bend down, pushing your hips forward as you come up. Reaching opposite ankle, foot, knee, shin, wherever you can reach. Nice stretch for the backs of the legs, nice spine rotation as well. Nice job, moving at your own pace, listening to your body. All right, and let's continue. We are gonna go into our last warm-up exercises, which is calf raises or heel raises. So feel free to hold on to something for balance. Heels come off the ground and then heels go back to the ground. Heels up or heels down. Feel free to do one at a time if that helps for balance as well. And then I also encourage you to take this time to stretch out anything else that maybe feels tight, you want to pay extra attention to. Now is your time to do that. I'm going to get a quick sip of water and then I'll break down our four moves for circuit one. All right. So circuit one, our four exercises are YTWs is the first one. Reverse leg lift is our second. Plank to floating tabletop is our third. And then a glute kick stick. So to break those down, our YTWs is our upper body exercise. So as if we were going to sing the YMCA song, stand with your feet in a comfortable position. So mine are about hip width apart. Lift your arms up to the ceiling and then they're a little bit out at a diagonal. So palms face forward, arms are up. Your whole body makes a Y shape. For the Ys, for the YTWs, from here you squeeze your shoulder blades together behind you and then release. So your arms move back behind you just a little bit. And then when you release, they just come back level with your side. So it's not a grand move. It's not a huge move, just a couple of inches as you squeeze those shoulder blades and then you release. Does anyone have any questions about the Y portion? Okay. And then the T is the same thing. So you put your arms in a T, squeeze your shoulder blades so your arms just travel back a little bit and then release. And then they come forward just a little bit so that they're back in level with your shoulders. And then the W, you put your arms into a W. So light bend in your elbows, palms still face forward, fingertips are up and squeezing those shoulder blades back again. For YTWs, there's no set one that you have to pick. So you have the option to only do Ys, Ts, or Ws. You can do a combination of them. You can trade them out during your exercise, whatever feels best to you. Choose your own adventure there. Does anyone have any questions about YTWs? Okay. Our next exercise is going to be a glute exercise. So we'll get onto our mats, stomach down. So we're going to lay down in a comfortable position, nose points down. You can put your arms however is comfortable for you. So if you want to cross your arms and rest your forehead on your arms, you can. If you want to have your elbows propped up, you can. The most important thing here is the isolation of the glutes, the lower body. So from here, it's a tiny movement, but you will feel it if you are engaging correctly. So pushing your hips down into the ground, you are going to lift your right leg just a few inches off the ground, squeezing your glutes as you do that, and then lower it. So lift it a few inches and lower it. And then do it on your left side as well. So you're just lifting and lowering, alternating, all in the lower body. So your upper body is completely still. Does anyone have any questions about this one? Your legs stay completely straight as we do that one. Okay, then the next one is a challenge. So feel free to modify. It's gonna be plank to floating tabletop. So this is our core exercise. This is really gonna fire up all your, it's a full core workout. So your entire abdominals are gonna get fired up. So plank to tabletop, I'm gonna do a plank on my full arms. So palms on the ground, wrists underneath shoulders, straight line from my head to my heels. This is my plank. And then I'm just going to bend my knees, shift back so that my hips go over my knees. So it's like a floating tabletop position or like cat cow, just floating your knees off the ground and then straighten them back out to your plank. So bend your knees, straighten back out. So plank to a hovering tabletop or like a hovering bear. Does anyone have any questions about that?
So your knees don't touch the ground, right?
Yes. But if that's an adaptation that anyone wants to make, they're welcome to drop their knees.
And you just move back and forth from straight plank to bended plank?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, just shifting your hips back so your hips hover over your hovering knees and then back to plank.
And ideally keep your legs straight through the entire movement. Is that right?
Yeah, so you'll keep your legs straight in plank, but then you will bend your knees as you shift your hips over your knees.
Okay.
So your knees will be bent at like an L shape, a 90 degree angle, as your shins are like parallel with the floor, hovering over the floor.
Okay.
It's a tough one, but I know you all can do it.
Yeah.
Any other questions about that one?
I like it. It's a good one.
And then the fourth one is our cardio. It's a glute kick stick. So I think Eric did a high knee stick with you guys before. It's going to be glute kicks at your own pace, and you hold the third one longer. So if you're doing a glute kick, you do 1, 2, 3, hold the third. 1, 2, 3, hold the third. So you just hold the third kick, every third kick for a second longer, and then you continue.
Got it.
Are there any other questions about any of these? Okay. Let's roll. Okay, I have the timer set for 30 seconds interval, 15 seconds rest. I'm going to pull up our music here. And I have an ad trying to play. Okay, starting our timer and starting our music. And let's start with YTWs. Let's go. Let me know if the music is too overbearing. Try to put it nice and low. So YTWs, you get your arms in a Y, a T, or a W shape. Squeeze those shoulder blades together, then release and repeat. Switching your Ys, Ts, and Ws, keeping them the same, whatever you want to do. 3, 2, 1, rest. Shake it out. Next up is our reverse leg lift. I'm going to get on the ground. Rest your head on your stomach. Or rest your head on the ground, you're on your stomach. And 3, 2, 1. Lift your leg using your glutes. Keep your leg straight. And then lower it, alternating back and forth. Reverse leg. Really squeezing those glutes. Strengthening your glutes is so important for your core, which then in turn is important for everything else we do. 3, 2, 1, rest. Our next is our plank to floating tabletop. So get ready for that one. Get into your plank, straight line from head to toe. Bend your knees so that your hips hover over your knees. So you shift your hips backward and then shift them forward. Back to your plank. Feel free to rest your knees if you need to at any point. Shins hovering, knees hovering, back stays flat. Don't forget to breathe here. 3, 2, 1, rest. Next is our glute kick stick. Shake it all out. 3, 2, 1, glute kick stick. 1, 2, 3, hold. 1, 2, 3, hold. Feel free to get your arms involved. Feel free to move at your own pace. Keep those knees pointing down as you do these glute kicks. 3, 2, 1. Take a nice deep breath. And we're resting. We're gonna go back to our YTWs now. Doing a little dance because I can't hold it in. 3, 2, 1, YTWs. Pick your poison here. The Ys, the Ts, the Ws, or all three. Maybe you pick two. Squeeze those shoulder blades together behind you and release. You choose your own pace. So if you want to hold the squeeze for longer, or if you want to do a shorter little pulse type contractions, Find what feels best for you. 3, 2, 1, and rest. We're gonna go, next is our reverse leg lift on the ground. If being on the ground is too much, feel free to do the standing, holding on to something for balance. 3, 2, 1, reverse leg lift, let's go. So you're on your front side of your body, lifting your leg just an inch off the ground and then switching. Lift, lift, lift to your own pace. Again, option to do the standing, holding on to something for balance. Our music theme today is 70s and 80s. Three, two, one, rest, shake it out. Our next move is plank to floating tabletop. Shake anything out that you need to shake out. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Plank, straight line from your head to your heels, and then shift your hips back to hover over your knees. Nice job hovering. This is a core activator as you move through the motion, staying stable. It's also a thigh burner. Plank as well. 3, 2, 1, rest. Next is our glute kick stick. That's already. Yeah, it's a burner, it'll get ya. Next is our glute kick stick in 3, 2, 1, go. Glute kick stick. 1, 2, 3, hold. 1, 2, 3, hold. I'm not going easy on you all today. Nice job, keep it up. Deep breaths as we keep going at your own pace. 3, 2, 1, active recovery, rest, whatever you want to do. I just keep dancing because I can't hold it in. That was already twice through, third time through. Here we go. Next up is YTW. 3, 2, 1. YTWs, let's go. I love this. I love the energy. Squeeze those shoulder blades together behind you. Lay down before I then do a move that kills you. What a treat. I'm so nice. 3, 2, 1, reverse leg lift. Either standing or laying on the front side of your body, lifting your leg up behind you just a few inches and then switching. If you're standing, it's just a slight kick back behind you, keeping your leg as straight as possible. Breathing through it. 3, 2, 1. And here's our recovery before our planks to table, floating tabletop. Keep breathing. 3, 2, 1. Right into it. Last one, plank to floating tabletop. Shift those hips back over your knees. Keep those shins hovering. I was moving pretty fast, but if you slow it down, you get more of a burn. Three, two, one, rest. One more move left, and that is our glute kick stick. I got the wiggle today for sure. All right, 3, 2, 1, glute kick stick. 1, 2, 3, hold. 1, 2, 3, hold. you have trouble counting like me, maybe it's not every third. Can't talk and count. Three, two, one, and that's a wrap on circuit one. Holy smokes, how does everyone feel?
Good.
Great.
Woo! Awesome. How's the 15 seconds?
I think it's good.
It's ample. Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Mara? Do I hear someone saying my name?
Yes, Crystal. Did we already do it four times?
Oh, we did it three. Are we supposed to do it four?
Oh, he usually does four. That's why I was like, yeah, we'll have time.
Okay.
It's your program, Tara. Just do what you want.
I changed it. I just added. So all the next ones we'll do through four times. We're not going easy today. I went easy on you and I didn't even know it. Okay. Okay. The next couple we'll do.
I have a request. Can you adjust the music down just a notch?
Yeah.
Not a whole lot, just a notch. Because with the vocals, it's kind of hard to hear you. You get drowned out.
Yep. I just moved it down. Perfect.
Okay. Thank you. Hope that's okay with everybody else.
All right. Circuit two, let's keep it moving. Our moves are push-ups, then we have clamshell toe taps, then we have bicycle crunches, and then we have high knee stick. So push-ups, push-ups on your knees, push-ups on your toes, push-ups on a wall. Does anyone need a description for push-ups? Okay. Next is clamshell toe taps. This is a glute exercise. So we're going to get onto our sides. So I'm on my left side. So I'm going to lay on my left side here and bring my knees in. So my knees are going to be bent to about a 90 degree angle, and then I'm going to slide them in towards my chest. My right leg is laying on top of my left leg, so they're stacked. My left elbow is on the ground underneath my left shoulder, and I'm going to open my chest to face forward and then a little bit up just so that my shoulders my chest is open and my shoulders aren't hunched. You have the option to put your hand behind your head, your right hand behind your head, or you can put your right hand on the ground in front of your torso. That's fine. From this position, does anyone have any questions about this position before I keep going? Okay. From this position, you're going to open your knees. So your toes stay together, but your knees come apart. And then you're going to switch. So knees come together, toes come apart. And then you keep switching. Toes together, knees apart, knees together, toes apart. So your knee comes up, your toe is down, and then your toe comes up, your knee goes down. And this is in hip rotation as well as the outside of your hip muscles. And for every round, we'll switch. So one round, we'll do it laying on our left. The next, we'll do it on our right. And then we'll switch for the other two rounds as well. Any questions about those? Okay, then we have bicycle crunches. So on your back, elbows behind your head, elbows nice and wide. Keeping your elbows wide keeps your shoulders open, your chest open, and makes you really do extra work, extra activation. So opposite shoulder, because your elbow is gonna be so wide, opposite shoulder to opposite knee, and then option to float the leg that is not reaching towards your shoulder. Just hover it off the ground straight, or option to just plant it on the ground with your knee bent. That's fine too. Any questions about bicycle crunches? And then in Pilates, it's the crisscross that we do. And then high knee stick is our last one. So the 1-2-3 hold, 1-2-3 hold, but with high knees this time instead of glute kicks. Are there any questions about any of those? Okay. Well, without further ado, let's keep going then. So I set it to four cycles. Let's hit play. And we're gonna start with push-ups. So 3, 2, 1. Get your hands underneath your shoulders or straight across from your shoulders if you're doing them on a wall. And you choose your activation. So if you wanna get your triceps, bend those elbows towards your rib cage, point them backwards. If you're looking for biceps, elbows go out to the sides. Get your hands a little bit wider than your shoulders. Keep that back nice and flat. Don't let your hips get low. 3, 2, 1, rest. Next up is our clamshell toe taps. I'm gonna start laying on the left side. Left elbow's under my left shoulder. Knees bent. 3, 2, 1. Clamshell toe taps. Toes together, knees apart. Knees together, toes apart. The closer you bend your knees in towards your chest on the ground, the more fire you'll feel in your glutes. So getting hip rotation as well as muscle activation. Three, two, one, rest. Next up is our bicycle crunches or our crisscross. So we'll get on our back. Three, two, one, and bicycle crunches. Opposite shoulder to opposite knee. Trying to keep your shoulder blades off the ground the entire time through that rotation. That's the challenge today. Opposite shoulder, opposite knee. Option to float that. Opposite leg, straight line off the ground. 3, 2, 1, rest. Next is high knee stick. So we'll stand up and do some high knees. And 3, 2, 1, high knees. 1, 2, 3, hold. 1, 2, 3, hold. Nice deep breaths. You've got this. It's our first round. Then we'll go into our second. 3, 2, 1, rest. We go into push-ups next. Back to take it from the top. First round done. Options for push-ups, knees, full length, or on the wall. 3, 2, 1, and push-ups, let's go. Remember, elbows out to the sides, biceps, elbows back, triceps. Back nice and flat. Your chest only lowers to the ground because of your arms. Don't let your hips help you here. Your whole body is frozen except for your arms. 3, 2, 1, rest. Next up, clamshell toe taps. I'm gonna lay on my right side this time. Right elbow underneath right shoulder, knees bent, pulled into your chest. Option to have hand behind your head. 3, 2, 1. Toes together, knees together. Rotation and activation. My left hip is always really tight, so I feel the burn right from the start. Through it, upper body stays completely still, isolating just that one leg that's moving. 3, 2, 1, and rest. We are gonna do bicycle crunches next or crisscross crunches. I can't help but dance when you rest. Okay, 3, 2, 1, bicycle crunches, hands behind head, elbows wide, opposite knee to opposite shoulder or armpit. And trying to keep those shoulder blades lifted off the ground between these every other is the challenge. Another challenge is to float that opposite leg off the ground, just hovering in between each switch. Option to have it planted on the ground. three, two, one, and rest. Next is high knee stick. Shake it out. And three, two, one. High knee stick. One, two, three, hold. One, two, three, hold. Or move at your own pace. Or just sprint it out. Keep up that energy. Three, two, one, and rest. We go back to the top. And because of Crystal, we have two more left. We go to push-ups next. In three, two, one, push-ups. Body stick straight. Pushing down. Or bending your elbows to let your chest come towards the floor. Straightening out, come up. Moving at your own pace. Back is flat. I feel the burn, I'm sweating. Three, two, one, and rest. Next is clamshell toe tap. We're back to our left side here. Laying on our left side, activating our right side. Three, two, one, clamshells. Toes apart, knees together, knees apart, toes together. Upper body stays still. Rotation and activation of our right hip. So our last glute exercise in the last circuit was our center glutes. These are our side glutes here. Three, two, one, and rest. Next up, bicycle crunches or cross crunches. Three, two, one, and exercise. Opposite, shoulder to opposite knee. Keep those shoulder blades lifted. Push your low back into the ground. Really feel the burn here. Push yourself past your limit. Really challenge yourself. Reach those legs longer. Deeper crunch. Three, two, one, rest. Next up is our high knee stick. Woohoo! I had to turn the fan on. Three, two, one, high knee stick. One, two, three, hold. One, two, three, hold. Take it at your own pace, but keep challenging yourself. You get out of the workout what you put in, right? So let's not give up on ourselves. Let's not give up on each other. Keep pushing forward. Hold each other to a high standard. Three, two, one, rest. Holy macaroni and cheese. Next up is push-up. Last round, coming right up. Three, two, one, push-up. You got this. Now we're in our last round, so don't get sloppy. Remember your form, back is flat. Chest comes down to the ground, but doesn't touch it. I'm gonna switch to tricep push-ups this time around to challenge myself. Three, two, one, rest. We move to clamshell toe taps. Last round of these, we're gonna be on our right side facing down, left side is activated. Three, two, one. Knees together, toes together, knees together, toes together. Beautiful. Upper body is still. Belly button is pulled back to spine for bonus core activation, bonus stability. Maybe we'll bring this to our core stability class next Monday. 3, 2, 1, rest. We go to bicycle crunches. Next, last round of bicycle crunches. Coming right up. And 3, 2, 1, let's hit it. Opposite shoulder to opposite knee. Keeping your shoulder blades lifted the entire duration is the challenge here. Push the low back into the ground. Deep breath. 3, 2, 1, rest. And we get up for one more round of high knee sticks. Woo!
Oh.
And 3, 2, 1. High knee stick. 1, 2, 3, hold. 1, 2, 3, hold. Beautiful. Last one of this round. So give it all your energy. You got a long break coming up while we go over the next circuit. Yay, we did it.
Yay.
Okay. We are going to keep moving forward to circuit 3. If you need to get a drink, now is a perfect time. We are running out of time. We might not get to our 4th circuit. That was a little ambitious, but let's keep going nonetheless. For circuit number 3, we have inchworms. So for inchworms, you start standing. So this is kind of like a core arms cardio combined into one. So start standing and then you do a forward fold, hands come to the ground, walk your hands out until you're in a full body plank. You can have the option to do a push up here, but you do not have to do that if you do not want to. And then you walk back up, you walk your hands back to your feet and then stand up. Option to do this on a wall, option to just reach down, reach up if your shoulders are feeling the burn. Any questions about inchworms? Okay. Next we have straight leg donkey kicks. So we're gonna get into our tabletop position. So my hands are underneath my shoulders, my knees are underneath my hips, and my back is flat. From here, extend your right leg behind you straight so that the top of your toes are touching the ground. And then you lift it up and then lift it down. So your right leg lifts, lowers. The key here is core engagement. So your leg is moving, but your back should not. So if you notice that your back is moving, pull your belly button closer to your spine to really isolate that movement to your lower body. With the isolation of that movement to your lower body, you're actually getting a really great core workout here as well. We'll alternate which side is doing the lifts every other circuit. So right leg first, left leg next.
I didn't quite follow that. So we started out in tabletop and then say the right leg extends all the way out.
Yeah, extends straight behind you.
Got it. Okay.
And then it comes down to touch the floor.
Oh, okay.
Yep. And then little lifts from there.
Lift from there and then back to the point of beginning. Got it.
Yep.
Okay. Thank you.
Of course. Does anyone else have any other questions about that one? Okay. So I think you all are familiar with donkey kicks. So it's kind of the same thing, except instead of having your leg bent, your leg is straight. Mm-hmm. Okay. And then our next move is toe tap. So you're going to get into a position as if you were to start a crunch or a sit up. So your feet are flat on the floor, knees pointed towards the ceiling. Your back is flat on the ground. Shoulders are on the ground. Head is rested. Put your arms and your hands by your sides, palms face down. And then all you're going to do is you're going to push your low back into the ground behind you. And then your toes are going to come off the ground. And then they're going to tap the ground. So your knees keep that bend, toes come up, toes tap the ground. So this activates your lower abs. Does anyone have any questions about this one? Oh, okay. And then our cardio is a squat pulse. So we'll stand up nice and tall. You can have, I like to have my feet about shoulder width apart for squats. Play around with it, find your happy place here. Toes point forward. Hands can go on your hips. Hands can go in a prayer position in front of your chest. And then you'll squat back. So when you squat back, your knees should track over your ankles. Toes stay planted. Back stays flat. And then you just pulse. So I'll squat back, pulse a couple times. Stand nice and tall up. When I stand up, I push my hips forward and then go back into my squat pulses. Stand up, push those hips forward. Any questions about those? Okay, well, let's keep at it then. I'll start our timer. I'll start our music. In 3, 2, 1, inchworm. Hands down to the ground, walk your hands out, plank position, option for push-up, or option to walk it back up. Stand it up nice and tall. Nice job, moving at your own pace. It's a full body exercise in itself. 3, 2, 1, rest. Let's do, get ready for our straight leg donkey kick. So getting into tabletop position, we'll do our right leg first. Shoulders overneath wrists, hips overneath knees. And exercise. So right leg straight back, taps the ground, lifts towards the ceiling. This movement might be just a few inches. Find your range of motion so you can keep your back entirely flat, entirely square. Belly button pulls to spine as you keep your legs straight and lift the torso down. 3, 2, 1, rest. Next up is our toe taps, our ab toe taps. So get onto your back, feet flat on the ground, knees pointed towards the ceiling. And 3, 2, 1, keep those knees bent, toes come up, and then lower to the ground. Key here is to have your low back glued to the ground. If your low back comes up, limit your range of motion here. Low back glued to the ground protects our low back. If it comes up, we're putting strain in our low back instead of our core, our lower abdominal muscles to accomplish this. Push your palms down into the ground, that helps. 3, 2, 1, rest. Next up is our squat pulses. And 3, 2, 1, squat pulses. Squat back, pulse a few times, stand up, push those hips forward. When you're squatting back, find your perfect range of motion. How far apart you want your feet, if it's shoulder width, if it's not. Your knees should track over your ankles. If your knees go past your ankles, then that means you're putting too much pressure in your knees. Come out of them a little bit. 3, 2, 1, rest. Inchworms are next. Nice deep breath. 3, 2, 1, inchworm it out. Reach down to the ground, walk your hands out, plank position, optional push-up, walk your hands back. Nice job, everybody. Sticking with us through this last circuit. We are staying alive. 3, 2, 1, rest. We're gonna go to our straight leg donkey kicks next. So get into our tabletop position. Nice deep breaths. 3, 2, 1, left leg extends straight behind us this time. In small lifts with our left leg straight behind us and back is flat. Hips are square to the ground. The belly button is pulled in to help stabilize our back here. Burner for those glutes. Nice job. Head is in line with your spine. 3, 2, 1, rest. We go to those toe taps next. Abdominal toe taps. Get on our back, feet flat on the floor, knees point towards the ceiling. And 3, 2, 1, low back pushes to the ground, lift those toes off the ground, push them back down to the ground. Nice job. Woo, you got this. Low back is glued to the ground, all on our low abs here, those stubborn low ab muscles, so hard to activate. 3, 2, 1, rest. Next is our squat and pulse. And 3, 2, 1, squat and pulse. Squat that, those hips back, pulse a few times, and lift and push those hips nice and high. You can hinge forward as you squat back, but keep your back nice and flat, pulling that belly button back to your spine. Helps keep you stable, helps keep the work in your thighs, hamstrings, glutes. 3, 2, 1, rest. And we take it back to the top with our inchworm snack. Halfway through. And 3, 2, 1, inchworm. Hands down, walk them out. Optional push-up, walk them back. Stand up nice and tall, move at your own pace. Take some time to activate when you get into that plank. Feel your form, feel your muscles engage before you walk it back. 3, 2, 1, rest. We are going back to those straight leg donkey kicks, so we'll activate our right leg again this time. So we get into tabletop position. In 3, 2, 1, extend that right leg straight back and little lift. Back is flat. Take a balance. An ice cream sundae on your back when it would not fall off. That's what I crave right about now. Good job, everybody. Keep it up. Last time on our right side here. 3, 2, 1, rest. And we go to those ab toe taps, those low ab activators. So getting on our back, feet flat on the ground, knees pointed towards the sky. 3, 2, 1, activate. Push your low back into the ground, lift your toes off the ground, and then let them rest back down on the ground. Low ab activating. They're so stubborn to activate. You might feel it, you might not. Keep at it. 3, 2, 1, rest. Amazing. Next is our squat pulses. And 3, 2, Squat pulses. Here we go. If your knees go past your toes, that's your range of motion right there, and I'm going further. Woo! I'm feeling it. Keep it up. 3, 2, 1, rest. We are there. We are have one more set left and then we get to cool down and it's gonna be amazing. Next is our inchworm. Last set of inchworms, so make it your best yet. 3, 2, 1, let's roll. Reach down, walk your hands out, plank or push up, walk your hands back. Wee-hee. We can say goodbye to these after this set. Amazing job. Keep that core activation, belly button pulled back to that spine this entire time. 3, 2, 1, rest. Back to those straight leg donkey kicks. So left side, last time. Left side, best side. Tabletop position. 3, 2, 1. Left leg straight behind you. Lift, lift, lift. Hips are square to the ground. Back is flat. Movement is coming just from that left leg. Upper body completely isolated and completely still. Nice deep breaths. Three, two, one, rest. We go to those lower ab toe taps next. Back is flat on the ground. Toes on the ground, knees bent towards the ceiling. 3, 2, 1, push lower back into the ground. Toes lift, toes tap. Woohoo! This is our last low ab exercise. The slower you go, the more burn you feel. I'm calling myself out because I was doing it really fast. 3, 2, 1, rest. One more exercise for the day and that is it. We're gonna do our squat pulses and it's gonna be amazing. And here we go. 3, 2, 1, squat pulses. Bend those knees, pulse it out. Stand up nice and tall, push those hips forward, squeeze the glutes, come up. Get deep with those pulses, back is flat. Push yourself here, last exercise. So we got to stretch it out, so take advantage here. Woo! And 3, 2, 1, and incredible. Stop our music here. How is everyone feeling?
Amazing.
Good, 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 good.
Good workout.
Our calm, yeah, hopefully I did Eric well. And
awesome job. Awesome job, Jeff. Thank you.
Thank you.
Those straight leg donkey kicks, that surprised me that was a burner.
yeah. And those, the ones where we were laying down in the first circuit, those kind of prep you, start the activation to get deeper in that third circuit there.
Yeah.
Woo. All right, we're in our cool down. I apologize, we only have a minute or so. So if you'd like to do a self-led cool down, feel free. If you'd like to follow along with me, feel free. I'm gonna do cat-cow position to get my abs and back pulled down first. So dipping my belly low from tabletop position to stretch those abs out, nose points forward. And then tucking your chin to your chest, nose points to your legs, arch your back up towards the ceiling, push through your hands, going through at your own pace. Yeah, it's a fun crowd. It's fun to do circuit. I don't think I've led a circuit workout in like a year.
My abs are burning.
but it's so fun. I would lead all the workouts if they would let me. All right, curl your toes under and then pike your hips up to the sky, straighten your legs for a pike position, also called downward dog, also called elephant. And then push your heels down to the ground for a deeper calf stretch. And then if you want to shift your hips back even further and then put your head between your arms, like your ears between your arms, that'll stretch out your spine even more too. And when you're ready, come down and out of that. It is 1 o'clock, so I'm going to stop our recording. Please feel free to stretch on your own.